50-22, a 22-0 run propelled by some great seniors and their senior leadership. A couple of those guys, Tommy Hannon and John Nance, well, they've been friends since their childhood, and earlier this week we had a chance to sit down and hear their incredible story.
Tommy and John they're kind of a dynamic duo because they've grown up together. They've known each other since they were in grade school, but they were at very different points in their athletic career throughout. John was kind of this prodigious athlete, one of the better young kids I've seen in the Twin Cities in the last 20 years, and could do anything he wanted with a basketball. And Tommy was probably not quite as naturally gifted, still a good player when he was young. And what you saw over the course of their careers was Tommy had a lot of bumps in the road. He got cut from a team as a junior, wasn't even on the JV, which is hard to do.
My best friends were all the star athletes, and you know, I was unathletic and cut from the team. So right there, that kind of made me motivate myself, and you know, these guys kept pushing me.
Instead of blaming other people, instead of pouting or whining, he really looked at it and said, okay, take a good look in the mirror, I've got to get better.
I knew Coach Tower ever since I was growing up. I went to his camps, and at first I was kind of like, why is he talking to me? He probably just wants my friend John. He kept coming to games and kept giving me a chance, and you know, I was a late bloomer, so looked like I had a little bit of potential in me.
I knew that if he put in the hard work, you know, he could do it here.
John, on the other hand, was the All-State football player, the All-State basketball player. He had a Division I scholarship, and things came a little easier to John.
John went to the U to play football his freshman year, and I could tell right away that he missed basketball a lot, and I just kept pushing him, you know, maybe give St. Thomas a try.
Here's John Nance, who had a scholarship to a Big Ten school, and he transferred to a Division III school, and he waited his turn, and he had to get better.
He was kind of the star, I'd say, and then I was just kind of the bench player.
John gets humbled a little bit, and to his credit, he looked in the mirror and said, I need to get better.
You know, who would have thought 3 years later we'd both be on the court, you know, lead the team in scoring and win a national championship. So it was pretty surreal. It was just awesome to think that two guys from St. Paul that grew up together playing baseball could be, you know, national champions and playing in Virginia. Something we never talked about, but was, you know, pretty awesome to be able to play these last 4 years together.
We're trying to put a great finish on it by winning another national championship, just going out on a bang, just having that senior year, having lots of memories and saying that we won it again.
Right now, St. Thomas on the way to that national championship run for the second time in 3 years. I talked to John Tower before, and he said those guys are the epitome of what he wants these St. Thomas basketball players to be about.